These gracious trees, Casuarina glauca, are commonly known as she oaks. They grow in windswept, salty sites that are inhospitable to other trees and are commonly found besides estuaries, as is the case here at Bayview near Sydney. Their needle-like leaves are actually long, segmented branches that have adapted to function as leaves. It wasn't until 1906 that botanists realised there was another species of plant growing on she oaks that closely mimicked it, the mistletoe and Anemone cambegii. You can see the mistletoe leaves are both lighter in colour and fleshier than those of the Casuarina, and they aren't segmented. Rich with sugar and carbohydrates, the spectacular fruit and blossoms of mistletoes brightly advertise themselves to birds. In this case, a noisy miner. There are about 90 species of mistletoe endemic to Australia. Notothixus is a genus of 8, and this one is golden mistletoe. It might better be called piggyback mistletoe because it grows only on other mistletoes. Dendroptha is a genus of about 30 species, and this one is probably Dendroptha vitellina. It normally favours eucalypts as a host, but here it is parasitising our she oak. And here again is our noisy miner feeding on it. Surely one of our most industrious birds. Another type of mistletoe that mimics eucalyptus trees but is thriving here in our Casuarina is Mullerina. In fact, this stand of Casuarina is host to at least 4 species of mistletoe, though to be fair, one of them is actually growing on another. The mistletoe bird is a striking little fellow, just 10 centimetres long. You can spot him at Bayview in August, but strong winds blow from the west in August, making it difficult to find him among the dancing branches. He gives himself away with his fast erratic flight between trees and his high-pitched voice. When you hear it, look for his bright red breast or undertail amongst the mistletoe blossom. Mistletoe birds are the principal agent for spreading mistletoe. Found throughout Australia, they are highly mobile, going wherever mistletoe is in fruit. Once eaten, the seed contained within the fruit passes through the bird within 10 to 15 minutes. Mistletoe seeds are sticky. If you chew one, you'll find it will adhere to your teeth. And of course, the bird knows this, so he sits sideways on a branch to defecate, because he needs to wipe the sticky mess off, and thus he sows another crop of mistletoe seeds in the tree with a dose of fertiliser for good measure. Though some seeds fall to the ground, many will adhere to the branch. Within days, a tiny green tendril emerges from the seed. It grows quickly, secreting a cocktail of enzymes directly onto the bark until a small hole forms. The tendril probes this hole, seeking its way through the sappy tissue until it hits the tree's payload of mineral-rich water. From here it will grow rapidly, so long as it gets plenty of light. The female mistletoe bird is rather more modest in appearance than the male. She lacks the red throat altogether, and the vertical black belly stripe is reduced to just a dusky grey streak. As if to reinforce the point about sticky seeds, she shifts her position strategically lower, defecates, and appears to wipe herself before climbing back to where she was before the urge took her. Here it is again in slow motion. You can clearly see the seeds separate from the liquid and adhere to the branch. It's only as she retreats that we can see that, like her partner, she too sports a pinkish-red undertail. Most mistletoes aren't entirely parasitic because they retain the ability to photosynthesize their own sugary food. But a single tree may carry up to 20 plants, and they can steal a substantial portion of the tree's water and minerals. Mistletoes might seem just another burden for an Australian landscape already under siege from drought, dieback and clearing for agriculture. But there's another side of this story. Many species of birds feed on mistletoe, including emus and cassowaries. So do possums, sugar gliders and even koalas. There are also butterfly larvae that eat mistletoe flowers, and some caterpillars can completely strip a mistletoe of its leaves in a matter of months. These are all important checks on mistletoe. Once birds and animals disappear from an area, there is little left to restrain it. Mistletoe infestation appears to be symptomatic of a much greater problem, the loss of equilibrium in too many of Australia's ecosystems. That is the result of greatly reduced natural habitat for our native birds and animals, and the decimation of their populations as a consequence. The way forward requires that we identify and address these imbalances. You can do this by regenerating our native plants on both private and public lands.
And that's it, plants in the ground.
And by putting up nesting boxes to encourage possums and gliders.